Morning students, here I am Bal Singh. Welcome you in the class 9 physics. Join your hands and first of all we surrender ourselves in the hands of God to keep us safe and sound. Thank you. Now today we discuss the first chapter of the physics is measurement and experimentation. First of all, this, what does it mean, the word measurement? Measurement is the comparison of known value to unknown. For example, your mother has asked, go and bring potatoes, go and bring milk. So the question first is how much? How much means it is to be compared by the known quantity. So same thing we will discuss today, measurement. Second part of the chapter is the experimentation. Experimentation by other instruments or by the other gadgets we use to verify these measurements. Second word is comes is estimation and measurement. Estimation and measurement are two different aspects. Both are necessary. For example, I have to buy the potatoes, I have to buy the sugar. The compared value is given equal and I can say it is 2 kg sugar or 2 liter of the milk. Clear? But if I am driving a vehicle, I can overtake this vehicle, I cannot overtake, by this space my vehicle can be passed or not passed. This is estimation. Two students in the class, they both were asked to stand up. The teacher asked who is taller and who is shorter. The student generally sees and says, this one, he is taller and B is smaller. Secondly, we ask who will be having more weight, who is having less weight. So they used to say A is having more weight, B is having less weight. But when the teacher asked, how much? No answer. How much? No answer. So this is called the estimation. This is different from the measurement. Now we come to measurement. Comparison of the given physical quantity with the known standard quantity of the same nature. If I have to measure the weight of the sugar, known quantity I have to compare. Clear? So comparison of the given physical quantity with the known standard quantity of the same nature. Nature should be same. Unit in which it is measured. Unit means from where it starts. Quantity of a constant magnitude used to measure the magnitude of other quantity of same nature. Constant magnitude used to measure the magnitude of other quantity of the same nature. So we can write physical quantity is the numerical value into unit. Physical quantity is equal to numeric value into unit. Second thing, choice of the unit. What kind of unit should be chosen? Number one, unit should be convenient in size, easy to write, convenient in size. Number two, should be possible to define the unit without ambiguity, it can be easily defined. For example, meter per second, how much distance is covered in 1 second? Meter per second, how much distance is covered by it in meter per second? It is a unit of the speed of the velocity. So it can be easily defined. Unit should be reproducible. Reproducible means meter per second. I will give an example. Meter is the unit of length, second is the unit of time, meter per second, distance covered upon time taken. So it can be reproducible. Number fourth point is value of the unit should not change with space and time. Value should remain same with the space and time, it should not vary. Kinds of unit. नंबर वन इज फंडामेंटल और बेसिक यूनिट, फंडामेंटल और बेसिक यूनिट इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एनी अदर यूनिट, डज नॉट डिपेंड्स ऑन एनी अदर यूनिट्स, फंडामेंटल और बेसिक यूनिट, इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन एनी अदर यूनिट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेंथ, लेंथ, लेंथ इज द डिस्टेंस इन बिटवीन द टू फिक्स्ड पॉइंट्स, मेजर्ड इन मीटर. सेकेंड इज मास, मास डज नॉट वेरी फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस, मास ऑफ द बॉडी इज सेम ऑन द अर्थ एज वेल एज सेम ऑन द मून, सो इट डज नॉट वेरी, सो इट इज फंडामेंटल. टाइम डज नॉट वेरी, टेम्परेचर डज नॉट वेरी विद टाइम, स्पेस और टाइम. डिराइव्ड यूनिट्स, राइट यूनिट्स, दोज यूनिट्स विच आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन फंडामेंटल यूनिट्स, दोज यूनिट्स विच आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन फंडामेंटल यूनिट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एरिया, आई हैव टू कैलकुलेट द एरिया ऑफ द रूम, आई शुड नो द लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ. लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ कैन बी लेंथ स्क्वायर, दिस यूनिट विल बी लेंथ स्क्वायर और लेंथ इनटू ब्रेथ, सो इट इज टू डायमेंशनल. सो दीज आर डिराइव्ड यूनिट्स टेकन फ्रॉम द फंडामेंटल यूनिट्स. वॉल्यूम, लेंथ इनटू ब्रेथ इनटू हाइट, आई टू कैलकुलेट द वॉल्यूम ऑफ दिस रूम, सो लेंथ इनटू ब्रेथ इनटू हाइट, सो दीज आर डिराइव्ड यूनिट्स. सिस्टम्स ऑफ द यूनिट, इनिशियली इन द ओल्डन टाइम्स they were following the different systems, like first of all French system was there, CGS system, in which the length is measured in centimeter, mass in gram and time in seconds. First system was CGS system, in which the length is measured in centimeter, mass in grams and time in seconds. Second is FPS system, British system. It was a foot pound system. Length is measured in feet. See, if I have to buy the rope, I said bring 50 feet. The length of the feet is my feet and your feet is different. So the measurement was not uniform. It was no uniformity. Arm length, feet, these measurements were not the same, not the uniform. So length was measured in feet, foot, mass in pound. Mass in pound, it is, if we compare today, it is near about 455 gram approximately. So mass in pound and time in seconds. So British pound, British system, it was FPS system. Then the system came finally, the MPS system or metric system, in which the length is measured in meter, mass in kilogram, time in seconds. Fundamental quantities, units and symbols in SI system, they are given the chart in your book. So according to this, quantity, unit, symbols, they are given. Quantity, unit and symbol. First, length, meter, started with a small m. Small m is the symbol. Mass in kilogram, kg. Time in second. Small s. So all these, they have given the chart in your book. By this, you just go through this and the symbols of this to write, to learn. This is to learn. This chart is to be learned. And after that, we will use this system in the other problems. Clear? Stop. Thank you.